I like how my Captain Mouse is just standing over here with his little tiny hat. He's still like wiggling his tail, like, I am controlling this bullshit of a shit. I guess I know Matt and welcome of Mice and Sand Revisit. Now, this is a game that originally has been, I think, developed on Nintendo Switch. However, now it's available on Steam. Now, I haven't never heard of this game. I have never played this thing because I don't know on Nintendo Switch. But it looked very interesting. And the music a little bit reminds me, well, at the beginning when the music started to play, it reminded me a little bit of Fallout. So, if you don't know, basically the idea is that you travel around in a, let's say, sand crawler, like the one you see on the screen, with a squad of mouses, and you are supposed to somehow develop? I'm not exactly sure how this is supposed to progress. As I said, I saw this game on Steam, looked really pretty cool, so I wanted to give it a try. So, without further ado, let's try to... Well, that was quick. That's a nice start, just saying. Okay. Oh, children of mice, hear me, brothers and sisters. The great calamity is that the desert dweller radiated his ugly head to reduce our home, our desert ship, to desert scrap. Great. Oh, what's this? We gathered up the pieces needed for rebuild the ship, but we are too far too old to explore the desert pot more. Youngers! The day has finally come for all of you to take up the search of El Dorado. It would be actually El Chisio, probably more appropriate for this thing. The desert ship is far too cramped for our entire clan to live their lives in it. Seeking out the treasures in the desert is our mouse clan's calling. Now go! Go forth upon our ship and live a rugged life in the desert. Great. Ah! Okay, so,
what's that? The ship doesn't have an engine and won't budget? You'll need an engine to get your ship over the bridge so you can choose your destination. It seems to recall seeing some engine parts lying around somewhere.
Ah, okay, so... touching? Acquire the... shirt iron, iron piece, bottle steel, okay.
There's nothing here but scraps and junk.
Well, let's keep looking. While you're looking for the engine, why not build a cargo room with the junk you found? It's easy, all you need is bottles and sheet iron. Okay. I'm cha-ching. How do I move? Use the button navigation. Okay, next to build. Yeah, I would try to take a look around first, okay? Thank you very bloody much. Pick up cargo room, try to build it. Okay, 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 okay. Okay, let's try this thing one more time. Can I collect the metals? Somehow. Can I order you to collect the metals somehow? I don't know. Okay, build. Right, cargo room, bridge, ladder. Let's you travel up floors. Okay, so let's build first the cargo room, build. And I'm guessing that I cannot go to the upper section of this thing because I don't have the ladder thing. Okay, so how do I order this thing to get built? Can I build this thing over here? Is it like set up? I have to build this thing here? I cannot build that in a different part of the ship? Okay, apparently I cannot. Okay, maybe this is just for the tutorial purposes. I don't know. Right, so they are now delivering the scraps. Building! So sweet. Okay, can I move to a different part of this thing? I don't know. I don't think so. Right. I don't know what you're trying to say to me, but okay. Yeah, you've built something. Cargo room complete. Awesome. If you have a cargo room, then mice will organize scattered items automatically. I'm looking. But it doesn't look like there is still a few scattered items up floor too. The mice need ladders to clean up the items up there. That's a must. Really. You don't even need any items to make a ladder. How cool. Now press the build, okay, so build the thing same as well, there we go, build this thing. Okay, build the ladder. Let's see, so after building the ladder, the mouse should automatically go upstairs and collect the items from there. So I think with those things, we'll be able to make ourselves the engine and we're gonna make our first adventure. Somehow, maybe, I don't know, we're gonna see. Build fast, there you go. Ladder complete, great. Now the mice can freely travel from the floor to floor. Which means you can retrieve those items on floor too.
Was there some feature in all of this?
Oh! It might come in handy later. We should hold into it. Acquire a bed. You can use it to construct sleeping quarters so the mice can get some rest. Awesome! Since you built a ladder, why not build a quarters on floor 2? As before, okay, I know, this is simple. So... sleeping quarters. Okay, build this thing and let's... Okay, apparently I cannot build this thing in a different section, so I just build it wherever I can. So, we've built a cargo, we've built a ladder, we're building sleeping quarters. So basically this is like a colony survival thingy, let's say Rimworld or maybe Oxygen Not Included, something similar like that thing. And then it's like actually the exploring involved as soon as I'm gonna get the freaking engine. Sleeping quarters complete. Great! Okay, and some rest, mouse, sleeping quarters, choose to stick to them, okay. The more sleeping quarters you build, the more the number of mice aboard the ship will increase. By building new rooms on the ship, you can do all sorts of things. Like increasing ship speed, crafting items, and much, much more. Rumbage.
Oh, there it is!
Ah, the engine! With this, you should all be set. Acquiring an engine, finally. Now, build engine room. Building engine room. Aha! The beating heart of your ship. Build more hearts to go faster. Okay, there you go. Huzzah! So the engine's on the front? You know, the engine needs to be in the back, so the ship will go faster, No, it's going forward, so the engine needs to be in the front. That's obvious physics, you didn't know? This is how physics works if you haven't been watching school. Okay, and this thing is constructing, so I also need a bridge. Engine will complete. The engine is the heart of the ship. Yes, I know! All we have to do now is construct a base so we can confirm your destination. You don't need any items to build the bridge. Just like before, press bridge something. Okay. So nice. Okay. Build the bridge. The cockpit. The thingy that will allow us to steer this magnificent beast. The behemoth of the sands. Guys, a little bit faster, please. Come on. Actually, I can increase the speed. Okay, there you go. Bridge complete. The map will now open. Select the bridge. Choose your next destination. Select the desired outpost and press enter.
It seems you're ready for a final test.
Get to the ship, Ronnie. You need to know how to operate the engine room. Select the engine room and operate engine to get going. Once you've got that fired up, select the bridge, choose the destination, and it's full speed ahead. Okay, so this. Okay. Aha, I have fuel. I need to worry about freaking fuel. That's nice. Okay. Tasks. Add task. What? Maintenance. Fuel. Wow, need to worry about refueling manually as well? Holy crap! Okay, so grab this fella, expel this fella, grab this fella, put him in the engine room, so he's gonna control this. Grab this fella and put him here.
Got it!
Okay, next select the bridge to bring up the map. Okay, this is the thing. Okay, so I need to go over here apparently. Shop, guest line, quarter quests available, free. Okay, I think we're ready to go. Sleeping quarters, add task. I don't want to add any task over there. Okay, do I have to take... No, I want to... Wait, how do I exit? Grab this fella. How do I make the engine run? Let's go! Finally got managed to do this thing. Got it. Yeah, but okay, do I have to... Okay, can pause the game, but this brings up the menu. How do I start the engine? Nabi. Remove. Remove the engine Nabi from the post. Yes. Assign. Oh, no, this is the different thing. How the hell I make the engine start? I'm so fucking dumb. This is the drive thingy. Engine. How do I operate engine speed? Stop engine. No, operate engine. Connect the engine to the main shaft. Is it okay? Yes. Aha. Okay. Now, this thing is set up. There you go.
Ready to depart. Full speed ahead.
Yay. Finally managed to get it going.
We have our final farewell gift for you. This is what we might call a secret to everybody.
What the hell? Receive an expensive looking golden pocket watch as a farewell gift.
If you need to sell it, should net you about 10,000. Gather all treasures you see scattered through the desert and use that money to make you to survive. Stay alive long enough to might even find the elusive El Dorado, the legendary land of gold of the east. We spend our whole lives looking for it. Maybe you will be finally able to find El Dorado. Since the time of our ancestors, mice have braved eastward journey over and over. The countless failures have shattered our dreams. There is one thing you must keep in mind. Terry, not in the desert.
The wretched desert dwellers will catch a whiff of your scent if you stop moving. And at the moment one does, it will stop at nothing to hunt you down. If you do not wish to lose your ship again, I would advise you to try not to run out of gas. If your ship runs out of fuel, you will be stranded in the middle of the desert, which will make you a lovely snack for the desert dwellers. Sweet. Lovely. That's what I wanted to hear. Your fuel is displayed on the... Okay. Right. The UI. Come home and check in with us whatever you like. Take care and stay safe. I got a freaking watch. What the fuck am I supposed to do with the watch? I don't know. Okay. We're on our way. Is there like something I can do? We are actually traveling. I thought it's gonna be like a loading screen or something. Maybe this is still gonna be. Yay! Now what? Drunk from the construction of the ship, litters on the ground. There might be some usable items in the clutter. Oh, wait, I see something. Wait, how do I gather this thing? It gathers automatically. Pick up an armful of low-fee scrap. No idea what that thing is for. Lots of items and scraps and ores are scattered across the desert. You can gather them up and sell them to make money. No money means no food nor fuel. And that means dying stranded in the desert. This income will be gained from scraps is but a sparkle of a sand in the financial desert. But there are ways to make real money of the national capital. Made from scrap gathering for now. Let's gather some scrap. Okay. No problem. Let's do so. If you construct a workbench, you should be able to salvage some items from the scraps. Oh, you pick it up enough scrap to build a workbench. Let's not waste time. Press the build button. Okay, I know. Select your new and build it workbench. Yada yada yada. Okay. I got it. Workbench. I want to build this thing in a different place, please. Aha. Now I can actually build this thing wherever I want. Build it next to the research room. Beautiful. I like how my Captain Mouse is just standing over here with his little tiny hat. He's still like wigging his tail. He's like, I am controlling this bullshit of a shit. I have the workshop. Now what I can do over here? A task. Bulk extraction, iron pipe extraction, repkey production, smelter up, enables crafting from high fee scrap. Need one guy, this is 15 stamina, 20 seconds, okay. So you turn the scrap into useful items. Okay, that's nice to know. I don't know, actually, should I try to do something? There's some information over here which I was not paying attention. Open the build menu and make a workbench. I already did. Oh, night has come. Choose the newly built room and try your hand at crafting items. Okay, so let's actually try to do something. Let's, for example, do the first one. Repeat. No, I would like to execute. Does this apply? He works over there. That's so cute. So, I'm guessing that later on, if you're gonna be expanding the ship, you're gonna have like shitloads of muscles going like left, right, and center. I kinda like wonder, is there like a room to make food? Smelter room? No. Ladder, bridge, cargo, sleeping quarters. Is there like more rooms actually later on? Like, is there like a possibility to, let's say, make a farm on the roof of the ship? Or maybe like a... I don't know, some solar panels in order to make like energy to fuel up the ship? Like, can you make like an electrical engine and power up with electricity? That'd be cool. Right? I don't know. Okay, we'll stay on our way. I don't know what's my map. Wait, do I see a map? Oh no, I only see where I'm going. It doesn't actually show me where I am at the moment. Okay. Hope for the best then. See something? Oh, that's the fueling station. Okay, do I need fuel? I think I have enough fuel at the moment. Gas. What's this?
We've got sight of a plant known as gas station, the winter storage depot. It's one of the desert's many outposts, a place to buy and sell things, including fuel and food, for the right price. Once you arrive at the outpost, use the tab on the highlighted outpost button in the bottom right of the screen and press it. This will allow you to buy and sell items and offer you aid in those who need of the quest page.
Hey! He looks like a cat. You there, on the desert ship!
Someone's an outpost was addressing us,
you don't say! I have a favor to ask, would you be willing to hear me out?
Yes?
Depending on how much you're paying,
the settlement appears to have a quest. Completing a quest couldn't be simpler. Just deliver the quest items you can craft within the different rooms on the ship from the items you've picked up. Clearing quests will earn you more money and items than merely selling you items at the store. Remember, ABQ, always be questing.
Wow! Okay, can you stop? Arriving upon the outpost, use the tab to highlight the outpost. Yeah, but I need to stop first. There you go. Yeah, you have stopped. Okay, outpost, what do we have? An outpost! You can select from fuel, market, outpost, quests and rumors. Select from any of those choices. Okay, rumors please. Let's see. Rumors will allow you to get the various types of information. If you buy a drink to one of the loiterers around the saloon, they might provide information on the type of items needed to build a new room or location of settlement you need to travel to next. Ah. Well, okay. 20 bucks. I have at the moment 0. Null. Nenada. Select any of those above. Yeah, I know already. Okay, so let's maybe go to request. Wanted. Okay. The desert not known for its bounty. Everybody wants something. Quest team for that. People commissions an item they need. Delivering the request item will earn you cash and item rewards more than you'll be getting by selling the items on the market. There are some clan here. Okay, not important. As the game progresses, you'll be able to craft more items, which will allow you to complete more quests. Yeah! Let's say. Okay, so. Deliver a bolt, and I'm gonna get fuel, I'm gonna get money. Ah! This thing? Synthesized cheese. Okay, I need to deliver an iron pipe. Fuel pump rounds, okay, whatever. Iron plate. Plea. Iron shit. Money and synthesized cheese. Okay, so. I've made some pipes when I was going here. So, for example. Wait, this one is giving me. This one's giving me fuel. Shit, should I try to get this thing? Because I'm almost at my limit on my fuel. Okay. Let's try to get this one first. Accept the quest. Iron plate, plea? Yes. Accepted the quest. Okay. Deliver. Deliver the quest? Yay! I got money! Receive the reward for accomplishing the quest. If there are any quests you think you could accomplish, you can't right now. Feel free to accept it anyway. You'll be okay if you have the request items by the next time you visit the outpost. I have the necessary items right away. There you go. Oh, I don't have a pipe? Okay, give me like a minute. Wait, fuel. Oh, I cannot go to the shop to the ship in order to build some items and then deliver them directly. Ah, fuck! The gold badge we received as a farewell gift is supposed to net 10,000 gold, but well, it doesn't fetch that price. I guess we'll be set for a while. You've sold the watch? I hope you didn't. Wait, what, how do I sell? Ah! Okay, the watch is worth 1,000. I'm not selling the watch! Screw you! Okay? Screw you in general! Okay, turret rounds. Jesus. Calorie stick. Synthesized cheese. Synthesized water. Do I need this water? Probably. Okay, let's buy two. I have a little bit of food, so that's not needed. Okay, buy this thing. Yes. Thank you. Not exactly sure how I'm supposed to use this water. I know! Fuel, yes. Fuel left, lets you refuel the ship. Yes, I know. We're in refueling. Okay. Simple enough, you know. I can dedicate this thing by my own. Fill them up. Reset. Purchase. Okay, I'm not doing this one. Can you please fuck off with this tutorial? It's really bloody annoying at the moment. Right, rumors please. Because I still have like a little bit of money left. So let's do cost of fuel. Button shortcuts. I'm done for. Cost of fuel. Yes. The price of fuel will increase as you go for the desert. If things get too expensive, just make your way back here. I see. Wow. I'm done for. When a mouse cares, I'm done for an expedition, it could mean he's starving to death, he's out of fuel. He's out of fuel, what? I mean, to fuel the mouse as well? Or he's encountered a powerful enemy. If all of you mice die, that's it. Furthermore, getting stranded will draft desert dwellers into your scent. And if your ship gets wrecked in the ensuring fight, it's all over. After the game over, you'll be taken back to the starting point with minus a large sum of your funds for repairs and other expenses. Well, that stinks. Okay, I don't think anything else I can do over here. Oh, I can craft the items I really want to. Okay. Ah, because this guy's still crafting. Ah, I ordered him to craft, I need to wait. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna wait a little tiny bit. Let him craft the thing and then I can go back to the outpost. There you go. So, bolt is delivered. And I ordered you to make a pipe. So I just have to like wait. Okay, waiting. There you go. Pipe is ready. So wait for the pipe to get delivered back to the storage room. And then we're gonna go to the outpost and finish the two remaining quests. Quests. Okay. Deliver the bolt, which I have done in the workshop. Deliver. Yes. Ah, so I received 100 fuel and I cannot go over the amount of fuel I'm like holding. Okay, that stinks a little bit. I just wasted like shitloads of fuel. Bravo me! Right, new destination have been picked up. Captain, take us on this hand. Let's go! Now saving. Please don't. Leaving the first outpost. Goodbye, guys! You are worthless piece of shit, just so you know. Won't be coming back for you, that's for sure. Right, my guy's still crafting some items in the workbench, so that's nice. Okay, let's enjoy the view. Ooh! What's this? This is new. Looks like a vault thingy or whatever. Okay, I would like to see... investigate this thing. What's this?
That's a container on the ground. Seems like a... antique. The door is flimsy shut.
Open it. Nah, open it.
So this is cheese! I don't know how it works, but you can leave it out for the 100 years and it won't spoil! Incredible!
Mice are probably getting hungry, remember? A full mouse is a happy mouse. It's always a good idea to have a little extra food lying around. Yeah, how do you feed them? Do they feed automatically or they have to build like a cantina or whatever? The cantina band of the mouse clan. Yeah! No, please don't. Okay, more scraps on the way. I'm supposed to like... I don't know what to do with you. Like... I'm supposed to tell you to feed yourself or something like that? Oh, what's this? I see something. Don't know what that thing is. Probably the game's gonna tell me. Hello? What's this?
Huh? There's a mouse collapsing in the sand over there. I'm starving. What should we do?
Let's give him the food we just picked up. We have a little extra cheese and maybe he'll join us.
So let's... yeah. You've saved me. We couldn't just leave him out here. He's good to have a new crew member.
The screen went black. Hey, have a new mouse. Welcome aboard, whatever your name is.
I thought we still had a little food, but the hungry mouse devoured in the blink. You probably noticed, but mice are living creatures and living is hungry work. When you select a mouse, the hung...
Okay, wait, he ate all of our cheese already? You will make it to Eldorado with starving mice. So be careful you don't run out of food. If your mice are starving, they'll eat anything and everything on the ship. If there are any items you wanna trade or keep, feed your mice. That's the best way to keep them from being eaten. Okay.
The mouse just picked up a certain single skill.
A mouse can give up a variety of tasks in different rooms. And sometimes executing them will grant a mouse a skill. A mouse with a skill will incorporate the skill-related rooms tasks faster. Try to assign a selected mice a room that will allow them to use their skills to the fullest. Okay. Right, grab the fell. Oh yeah, no, this thing already did. Okay. Whatever. Fuck off. Thank you. What the fuck is doing? Hey! Dude! What he's doing? No, this is... What are you doing? Excuse me very bloody much. Crafty master, workbench, wonderkind. Okay, and the other guy? No, this is the same guy. Wait. Okay, grab this fella and assign him here.
Let's do this!
Okay, so you are assigned to the workbench, I believe. What? Oh, another mouse.
That's another standard mouse. So exhausted, so sleepy.
What should we do? Let's bring him aboard. We should have some space in our sleepy quarters. I have 4 spaces on 3, so...
You saved me! It would break my heart to just leave him here. Let's take him with us. Our crew grows by the day!
Yeah, I don't know if actually this is a good thing or a bad thing. I don't know, we're gonna see. Pretty soon, probably. Sell them to captivity, to slavery, if we have to. Okay, mouse with no stamina. Mouse with no stamina is unable to take any other task until the stamina is fully restored. The mouse is completely spent. Its stamina will not recover until it's rested in the sleeping quarters. I know, okay, get it, simple. We're going to have a single sleeping quarters which can house 4 mice. Select a sleeping quarters to view how many mice we have. Yes! Fucking tutorials, get out of my face! Oh, he's sleeping. So he's actually like snoring like a pig, what the hell. Right! Collecting more scraps. Beautiful, okay. Ooh, how far to the next outpost, Captain? Wish I would know. Mines! What?
There's some real villains out here. Some bandits must have set up as a trap and forgotten about it. Nobody wants hurt, but our ship took some damage, which means it's time for repairs.
If you have a repair kit, when this ship takes damage, the mice will repair it on their own. You can make repair kits by combining bolts and sheet iron on the workbench. You never know what could happen in the desert. Be sure to keep several repair kits on hand. Ah, fuck. Look at that! There's actually a repair kit on the ground right now! The explosion must have unearthed it. The repairs will start right away. If you're in a situation more damage, okay, I get it. Need more repair items in order to repair the ship. Simple enough. Oh my god, okay, no, don't want to do anything with this thing. How do I exit? Once I pick up somebody, I want to craft some items. Repair kit, iron pit, okay, I want to craft some of this. Just in case if I need this thing in the next outpost I'm gonna visit, so craft all of those. Okay, how much metal scraps do I have? I have 7 scraps, right? So I could technically craft 2 of each. I don't know, should I do that thing for now? Okay, I'm gonna leave it as this. Okay, speed up the game a little tiny bit. Speed up a bit more. Yeah. What the hell? Wow.
The ship, Queen of the Plains, come into the view. Long ago, during the age of the Great Escape, this ship fell from the sky. Those who lived here today are the descendants of the people who crash-landed here. Alright, it's uncharted territory from here on out. Getting lost would be bad news. We stumbled around in the desert until unbearable, horrifying deaths. At the time, like this, we need to ask for directions. If you roll into the tavern or buy a drink for a friendly local alcoholic, they might share some handy information.
You can also by selecting room. I know! Wait, this is an outpost? When you arrive at the outpost, select rumors. I know! Christ, this tutorial mission, man. There you go. Okay, stop the engine. Just in case, because I don't know. Is this actually like a thing? Yes, okay. Engine have been stopped. Right. Mouse, stay on board. I'm gonna go to the outpost and see what we can get. Quests. First things first. Motor repairs. Okay, need to deliver coil. Cannot do that thing. Deliver coil. Bolts. Need 3 bolts.
Okay, that sounds easy enough. No problem. Rumors.
Let's see what you have. Oh my god. Saving fuel. Improving a room. New location. Room building. He who smelled it. Okay. I would like to get some information about that thing, please. You can pick up all sorts of odds at the end of the desert, but if you're making the market for iron, it's the best to melt it all down. If you're interested, you should get some bricks and build yourself an oven. Give it a workbench and upgrade or two, and you should be able to extract bricks from whatever scraps you find. I see. No idea how that's supposed to help me. And a new location, the Southern Lighthouse. You can see the stickable object in the south. Many, many years ago, that thing used to shine. Ships use it as a landmark and would head towards it. If you don't have anywhere else to go, why don't do the same? Okay, and I'm out of money, so I need to craft some bolts on the workbench. So come on, chop chop. Get the bolts finally. Come on, drop them to the storage depot. Okay, quests, and what is it? This one, deliver. Yes. Yeah, I got money. So now with this money, we're gonna go to the rumors things. No, rumors, it said. Okay, improving a room. Listen, yes.
Take a good look at your task list. See those things with the assigns? Perform one of those tasks to upgrade that room. You might want to start with a workbench. You'll be able to make more items out of the scrap.
I have some. Saving fuel. Those who wear helmets.
A large number of earthlings boarded the ship way back when the descendants still roam around those parts. You should hear if speak. It's crazy. They're always wearing helmets too. Seems that the planet atmosphere affected their health.
Oh, that's nice. Salvaging fuel.
Wanna buy some fuel? Long, long ago, I used to, all of this fuel to fly through the sky. Honestly, I have enough to reach another planet. Not that
there is anywhere I want to go. Great. Okay, whatever, man. Whatever. I'm not judging you. I'm not judging. Okay, so we need to set up the next destination. Okay, this thing is available for us to go. So, let's go. Start the engine. There we go. And I can now improve the rooms, right? So, let's see.
Alas, our journey is finally proceeding to the ear nest. Explore just outside the outpost to collect scraps and other items. Then, take the items to craft.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Okay. That's basically how the journey is going to flow. Awesome. Can you get rid of the freaking tutorials? I'm already bored of them. How long can you like have tutorials? Okay. How I can improve the workbench? That's a pretty good question. Ah, a task? No. How do I improve this thing? I don't know. So each one of those rooms has like the task thingy that I can try to use in order to upgrade it. So for example, the sleeping quarters have double beds, cleaner sheets, armor up, increase the room HP, and the engine I think has something similar. Refueling, stronger cylinder, increases the speed, bypass limiter, enables limited removal. And the workbench? Tasks? A task? Ah, there it is. Okay. Enables crafting from high-fee scraps. I need boss and I need iron pipes. Constructor up. Enables item assembly. Oh, that sounds nice. Armor up. Okay, so I think I need to gather more scraps in order to actually do something. Wait, how many scraps do I have? Items? I have 4. Not much if I can be completely honest over here. So I got a little bit of this thing. Constructor up. Okay, I would like to get this thing actually. So I need 2 more iron pipes. I need 2 more bolts. I need 2 more iron sheets. Okay, that should be easy to do. Oh good, I have arrived at the lighthouse. Still gathering the items needed to upgrade the workbench. So let's see what the outpost actually needs from me. Quests. Wires, okay. Wires. Iron sheet. Oh, that's nice. I already have this item. So I can accept this thing. And deliver it right to... Oh no, you need 10. Oh. Okay, I think still I can craft those things without any problem. Now, at task, can I finally upgrade this thing? Enables crafting? No. Assembly item. I need one bolt, I need one more metal sheet. Night has come and my worker decided to take a quick break in the bed. So he's at the moment resting. That means I'm not making any more items for me to trade with. So I think actually this is a good point to cut this episode over here. I'm gonna pause like the game actually. So yeah. Interesting title. It's very calming for now. Like right now, I'm not feeling the pressure. Maybe because I still have like at the beginning of the game, so I have still fuel, I still have food. I have a little bit of scraps. I can try to do something. I had a little bit of money, so I can try to do something with that money as well. So no pressure at the moment. But I'm guessing that the more game is gonna develop, there's gonna be more pressure actually pushing towards me. I don't know. We're gonna see. Enjoying it so far, and if you want to try it yourself, I'll leave you a link to the description below. As I said, interesting title, especially if you're like a fan of those colony survival type games, so let's say like Sheltered, Rimworld, Oxygen Not Included, something like that. I'm not exactly sure how the mid game of this looks. Apparently at the beginning you just like food, fuel, scraps, food, fuel, scraps, food, fuel, scraps. But I can buy ammunition, for example, from the shop. So that means that probably at some point you have to make maybe turrets and actually defend yourself from incoming invaders. I don't know. Let me know what you think about the title. I'm gonna probably try to give it one more shot and try to maybe get into some combat. And after that, we're gonna make like a decision to keep rolling the series or maybe just cut it on like, I don't know, 3 or 2 episodes. I don't know. We're gonna see. For now, I think actually I'm gonna cut it as it is over here. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you liked the episode, please subscribe a lot. That's y'all. In the next video.